the pickup we have, or the Land Rover we have, is a a removable back, so we can turn it into a pickup and carry small things around. Okay, so I guess I could do a quick step through our equipment. Linda kind of needs a service. What's that? That's the Axion needs a service. That's the Harvester. Okay. No big deal. How's our sheep doing again? So sheep have all the water, all the hay, not much of the cleanliness, and point 3 years. So 0.3 years. Oh, actually, it's mid fall now. So tomorrow's late fall. So we'll start seeing sheep increases come winter. Oh, let's feed the dog. Hey, dog. Yoo-hoo. Looks like he's run off. Stuck. Anyway, I am going to fast wind the rest of today because we are kind of done until best canola day sale. Let's have a look. Jump in the bedroom. That one. Canola best day is first day of winter. So that's when we want to sell our canola crops. If we have some. Canola. That's the canola crops. Hilltop and Willowbrook. So Willowbrook's the main store. That's fine. No, we don't have any canola. We have sunflower oats and wheat. Okay. Sunflowers, oats and wheats. Wheats is 3 winter. Oats is 4 winter. And sunflowers is nowhere near soon. And this is 4 winter, 3 winter. So as time goes, we'll sell more. But really, oh. Wool. Wool's not till spring. So we're not doing anything with the wool. So for right now, we are fast winding time and feeding sheep on a semi-regular basis. Until winter. So, as I said last week, this is where things go a little bit faster and not much happens. I think I have the ability to bump that up to times 2000. Oh yeah. 5, 6, 7. Okay, let's go there and sleep for 12 hours, I reckon. Vehicle running costs, property maintenance, rain. Lovely. Animals. Animals need food. So I'm gonna jump to the Lindra. And it's gonna be another dark day, so okay, let's do that. Garage. Bale spike. Sell that. And back. Front loader arm. Fork with reclining tips. Don't need a bale grabber. Don't need those. Lifting hook, no. Something like that. Okay. Front loader. Bye. Yes. Okay. Back. 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 And we'll get that delivered to the farm. That's not what I'm looking for. That's what I'm looking for. Okay. So that got delivered to the farm. I don't think I got that on the farm. Okay. To anything, so I will. Once we get a little bit of cash, it's gonna cost about 60,000 to upgrade this to the 130 over the 90. I don't think it's a big deal doing that. Now we can pick up a ton of bales. Well, we can't pick up a ton of bales because this is a small tractor. But now we can pick up a couple of bales at least. Stack them. Get as close as I can to being in the corner, then I'll take two from the second row. Cannot see a thing. I think that's about right. What's the buttons for? Do a thing. Put back roads, try not to knock over half the bales. Try not to get to pound them on the floor either. Okay. We'll turn the help screw. to. Oh, it's raining. Crap. 7:34, that's okay. Yeah, we're playing with seasons. This is bales of hay. Bales of hay do not like the weather. Do not want to be carrying around bales of hay in the open when there's weather. Did I lose a bale? Oh no. That one's not stabbed. Bales 15. That's 15. There's room for one more, I would guess. Okay. We'll go get the green one. Oh, and try not to drive in the trough. That would be a plan. I think as we enter winter, I'm seriously not going to bother getting up at 7:30 in the morning. Before 8 o'clock comes around and we lose any hay from bales that are outside. So this green one is the last one we bought when I started the farm. Everything now remaining on the farm is a self-grown bale. For this farm, a Lindner is better than the new Rigitrack tractors. The Rigitrack's a very long wheelbase, and while they're four-wheel steer, yeah, that wheelbase length could be a problem. Alright, check that out there, and break that bale. Check the state, we are full, yes. So, sheep are dealt with. I'm kind of wondering whether the 130 has a slightly taller frame, and thus won't round out the FL30. The sheep dealt with. I'll drive down the back, we'll check the silage now. Again, I think for the rest of the day we can probably sit indoors and watch the rainfall. The Silage and 88%. What percent of 2 days is 3 hours? So that might be ready by 10. Okay. Okay, see if I can figure out where our shed is. About here. Oh, we've got all the bays in the world here. We parked the fent around the back where the sugar beets are. Alright, we will. Rest. And let's. Oh, there was another level of lighting. Oh well. There we go. Oh, I have outside lights. That's good. I know this shed has inside lights. Don't want to run anywhere. So we'll go and wait it out. Hi doggy. Should we feed the dog again? You should get in your house. It's kind of wet out here. In here, there's just no light in the bedroom or the bathroom or the kitchen. Speed up time. We want to get to about 10 o'clock. 10, that'll be fine. Okay, still raining. Run down and check the silage again. So the ground is wet, no surprises there. We have rain with just dull later. Oh, and I could have looked at 95%. So it should be ready by about lunchtime and. Look up contracts because, yeah, just the 4 baling contracts and a transporting contract. Really not too worried about those. So I think we'll run through to about 1 o'clock in the afternoon. Maybe before. 99%. Ugh. And come on, come on, come on. Boom. We have fermented silage. Yay. Oh, and the rain stopped. That's even better. Discovered you can't move those tires. You can, but they just go back to where they started. Knife. Turn on belt. There we go. Whoa. And jump out. Alrighty, let's get this thing this at the end of that one. A great deal under 10 players still was indeed, huh? Alright, let's figure out how this thing works again. It's fine. Jump out of that and reverse the truck in. Awesome. Okay, let's check out on that. Look at that oat. 1103. Okay. And oats. 1103 puts it close enough to there. So it's really no difference. We're still going to get much better price in a few days' time. So not even bothered. So let's go make some digestate stuff. I forgot to turn my speakers on. I think it still comes through on the stream. It's just that I haven't been able to hear it. And it's still raining. I thought it had finished. And yeah, this does take a while. So our loading wagon we're using this one. It's 2130. Interesting. That's interesting. That's actually a different one. 33DT. 2130. That's only 2500. 90 horse, 60 horse. This needs less horsepower to run, but takes more. This one, same horsepower, but carries less. So we could update it or upgrade it a little. That's only a little bit more expensive. Oh well. Has the silage. Yeah. Let's back it up a bit so we fill the front of the trailer. So what else do I need to do on the farm? I could put all my consumables out. Well, no. Yes, no. Shed where I put the fend. I could put the consumables there. Always an option. Because I don't use it otherwise, but then what am I going to use that shed for? But that other shed, it's difficult to get things like the cedars and other big equipment that we have back there. I think it's good where there are at the moment. Huh? Demand was a canola, right? Yeah. No. Oats. But we're not interested because frankly, that price sucks compared with maximum. Oh, and it stopped raining, yay. And we are full go. I wonder if those do reset down. I just can't remember. They only move when it's raining. Okay, roll down to the store. I think once I get to the store, we'll put the time up to times 5 because it'll allow the digester to process. It may actually be easier if this truck was right-hand drive rather than left. Driven a car in France with the steering wheel on the right, and that was scary. And I've been a passenger in a car with the steering on the left in the UK, and that too was scary, because driving down these sorts of roads in a car behind trucks, and the driver can't actually see what's coming the other way when he pulls out to overtake. Passenger can. Okay. Get down to 50. Fortunately, no speed cameras on this map, so I won't get done for speeding. No, the truck's only capable of 53 maximum. Kilometers an hour maximum. I'm not sure. Come on, car. You do get spoiled with the newer maps where the cars go 5-10 miles an hour faster than that. All right, here we are. Place we're going to spend a lot of today, I would guess. And that is not quite a full load for the processor.